Hi, I'm Andrew from AWS.
Hi, I'm Chris from CCC, and this is My Architecture.
Thanks for being here on the show, Chris. What do you guys do at CCC, and what problem are you solving with this architecture on AWS?
So CCC, we work in the property and casualty industry, and we create a lot of products for a variety of types of companies. So insurance companies, body shops, parts suppliers, and everything in between. So what we were trying to solve with this architecture is how we can more easily manage all of our current and future AI solutions. As we create more models, our solutions get more complex, and we wanted to find out how we can use managed services to remove some of the burden on our development teams for managing all of this.
Wonderful. So let's walk through one of those examples.
So one of the examples that we have is a product called Estimate STP, straight through processing. So the typical flow of this product is when a policyholder gets in an accident, they submit their photos to the insurance company, and then we ultimately produce line level estimates for the insurance company to use and make business decisions on.
Okay, and then how do they initiate the request?
Yeah, so the application would first send in a request through API Gateway, signaling which service they'd like to use, in this case, Estimate STP, along with sending a callback URL so that the platform can notify them once the prediction is ready. So that goes through a Lambda function, and then that Lambda function creates a unique prediction ID to track the entire transaction, and then creates a database record for tracking, and then it produces a pre-signed S3 URL that is then returned to the application. And that pre-signed URL is used to upload the vehicle photos and other information related to the claim into S3.
I see. So why could the user, in this case, the insurance firm, not upload that information straight through the API gateway in the first transaction?
So we encountered payload limitations when using API Gateway. Because we deal with photos that are always increasing in resolution, we needed to bypass that limitation and go directly to S3.
Wonderful. So this is kind of one step of the process, right? So you initiate the request, you upload the files. What's the next thing that happens?
Yeah. So once the input is uploaded to S3, we have a listener on these buckets to then create a message that is sent to Lambda. And that Lambda function will then do a quick lookup on our database table and identify which step function needs to be invoked to initiate the predictions that need to be used.
I see.
So it'll send in the S3 pointers for the user's original input and the location of where the output needs to be saved at the end.
Okay, so let's dive into the step function and see the logic behind it. So how would that work if you could maybe describe this to our viewers?
Yeah, so we use step functions to orchestrate all of the steps that need to run for any given AI ensemble. So an AI ensemble for us is really just a collection of AI services that work together to produce one final output. So all of these nodes in the graph represent individual AI models that need to work in parallel or in sequence, depending on what their input is.
So these AI models, I see SageMaker, is that what you use?
Correct. Each of these nodes represent an AI model that is hosted using asynchronous endpoints on SageMaker.
Okay, and how do you invoke that?
So each node in the step function will be calling a unique AI model that is hosted in SageMaker. So when the payload is sent to an endpoint, the prediction is made, and that's automatically saved in S3. And then once the prediction is complete, a notification is created, and a Lambda function will consume that and then send back a token to the step function, notifying it that it can now continue on to the next node in the graph.
To the second step.
And this repeats until all of the steps in the graph are complete.
So assume that the insurance firm uploads an image that is invalid. How do you address this with this architecture?
So if the user input doesn't meet the minimum requirements for running the entire AI ensemble, What we do is we run input validation in the very beginning to ensure that we don't run downstream AI models unnecessarily, and the user's notified immediately if they don't provide
and
correct
input. And you can remediate that. Okay. And then after sort of going through an ensemble, what do you get? What do you find after the last kind of step?
Right. So in this case of Estimate STP, we produce line level estimates, and all of that information is then automatically saved in S3 using the original input from this step, where we save the output in a predefined location. Once that final prediction is saved in S3, we have a Lambda function that will query our database table to grab the callback URL that the user originally provided.
Okay.
So with that callback URL, the Lambda function will create a pre-signed S3 URL and send that back to the user. And that user will then use the pre-signed URL to download the final output from S3.
Chris, I'm sure you're doing this at scale. How many transactions are you handling per week?
We're handling about 4.1 million transactions.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you so much, Chris, for sharing this architecture.
Thank you.